Hello students, welcome back to your science class. So students, in the previous class in this chapter, that is acid, bases and salts, we were talking about their properties. See, we had seen up to that what are indicators, as well as we have understood what are acids. Acids, they are basically classified into concentrated and dilute. And how can we say that it's a concentrated, more amount of a solute will be there, that will be a concentrated only. How can you convert a concentrated into dilute? So we never add the acid into the we never add the water into the acid, but acid into the water by Coster's theory with the help of a glass rod. Then we started to understand that of what kind of a reaction an acid will show with that of the metals. So if we talk about the acid react with the metal, acid plus metal, we know that it will give the salt plus hydrogen gas will be evolved with it. Hydrogen gas. Acid plus metal, that will give salt plus plus hydrogen gas. See here students, one more thing that you must know. Suppose if we have taken the sulfuric acid and when we will add zinc granules in it, you will find that the zinc granules, the reaction between this will be really exothermic. It will produce a lot of heat. And when you bring a burning splinter near to that of the mouth of the test tube where you had where this reaction is taking place between that of the sulfuric acid and zinc, you will find that it will produce this pop sound. So with the help of which we are able to detect that the gas which is evolving from it, it is a hydrogen gas. And the test tube is what is consisting of the salt which is zinc sulfate. So zinc reacting with the sulfuric acid, it will provide zinc sulfate plus hydrogen gases evolver. So any acid react with the metal produces salt and that of the hydrogen gas also evolved. Now let us see what happened when the reaction of the acid occur with that of the metal carbonate or metal hydrogen carbonate. So reaction with the reaction with the metal carbonates. Reaction with metal carbonates. So when the acid it react with the metal carbonate, then there is a formation of a salt plus carbon dioxide is released and water is also released with it. Okay, so if any of the acid, if you take students, like hydrochloric acid is there, and this hydrochloric acid react with the metal carbonate, that is Na2CO3. So sodium carbonate is a metal carbonate. Then there is a formation of a sodium chloride, which is a salt. CO2 is released and H2O is released. We have seen this reaction earlier also. Now if you look at the reaction, the same reaction if you will see with the with that of the metal hydrogen carbonate. So when the acid react with the metal hydrogen carbonate, then there is a formation of again salt plus carbon dioxide plus water. So if HCl is reacting with that of NaHCO3, then there is a formation of NaCl plus CO2 plus H2O. Okay, sodium chloride, which is an aqueous solution, then gas, and then liquid. This is also an aqueous solution, aqueous liquid. Okay, so okay, now the whether this reaction is balanced or not, so there are two hydrogen are two here, sodium is one, chlorine is one, carbon is one, and oxygen is three here, so it is a balanced one. Let us see here, here hydrogen is 1, here hydrogen is 2. So we will going to put here 2. Now 2 chlorine, chlorine is again 1 here. So 2. So 2 hydrogen, 2 hydrogen, 2 chlorine, 2 chlorine, 2 sodium. Sodium is also 2, carbon is 1 and oxygen is 3. Now it is balanced. So in both of the cases we will find that whether acid react with the metal carbonate or it react with the metal hydrogen carbonate, there is a formation of a salt, there is a formation of a carbon dioxide and water. Okay. Like if we take an example, instead of hydrochloric acid, if we will take here sulfuric acid, then what kind of a salt formation occur? Because carbon dioxide and water will release in both of the cases. So let us see what kind of a salt will be formed here. So if we'll take here H2SO4, and if they in the reaction, if H2SO4 reacting here with Na2SO4, then there is a formation of a sodium carbonate, then there is a formation of a sodium sulfate, Na2SO4. So you can see here sodium is balanced again, sulfate it is balanced, hydrogen, carbon is balanced and oxygen. So it is already balanced here. Similarly in case of here, if we will made it to react with the H2SO4, then there is a formation of a, again Na2SO4, H2O plus. Now it is not a balanced one, so we are going to balance it. So how many sodium are there? Sodium is 2, so we will write here 2. Now sodium is balanced, sulfur in both of them it is balanced, hydrogen it is 2 and here hydrogen is 2, so we will going to write here 2. Now hydrogen is also 4, hydrogen is also balanced, carbon it is already balanced and oxygen. So oxygen is here 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 3 into 2, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. So it will be 10. It is 8. Now it is 4, 8 and then 10. So now carbon and oxygen, all of them are balanced. Now this reaction is balanced here. So in both of the cases you find out that metal carbonate or metal hydrogen carbonate, when react with the acid, then there is a formation of a salt, carbon dioxide and hydrogen gas is also released along with it. So suppose we have taken that of the metal carbonate in a test tube, and when we mix a acid into it, covering it with a cork, then the gas which is released through it is a carbon dioxide gas. How we will come to know about it? So we will take the test tube and the gas which is released, if you take a delivery tube, cork with a delivery tube, so the gas comes out through the delivery tube. Now this delivery tube is connected to another test tube which is consisting of a lime water, and we know that the property of the carbon dioxide that it turns the lime water milky. So suppose in a test tube we have taken both of the reactant, sodium carbonate and sulfuric acid, and we had covered it with a cork which is fitted with the delivery tube. Now this delivery tube, other end of the delivery tube is there with the another test tube which is filled with the lime water. Now the carbon dioxide released when entered into the lime water, it will turn lime water milky. Okay. So this is how we can prove that the gas which is releases out through this reaction is the carbon dioxide gas. Now let us see the reaction with the bases. What happened when the acid react with bases? Reaction with the bases. So what happened when the acid react with the bases? So acid when react with bases, then there is a formation of a salt, plus water. And this reaction is what? This reaction is called as neutralization reaction, where the acid is reacting with the base layer. Okay? Reaction is called as a neutralization reaction. Now, hydrofluoric acid, when react with the sodium hydroxide, which is NaOH, then there is a formation of a sodium chloride, that is NaCl, and water is also released along with it. So here it is liquid, it is in the form of an aqueous solution, there also an aqueous, and here also it is an aqueous solution. Okay, so when the acid react with that of base, then there is a formation of a salt, and water is also released along with it. Like if we take another example, sulfuric acid. So sulfuric acid, when react with the sodium hydroxide, then sodium hydroxide is a very strong base student, and sodium hydrochloric acid and sulfuric acid, that is also a very strong acid. So both of them, they react together to form the sodium sulfate, which is a salt, Na2SO4 plus water is also released along with it, okay, which is in the liquid form. Now let us see whether this reaction is balanced or not. So you will find that the sodium is here 2, it is 1. So we will balance it by writing here 2. Now sodium is balanced at both the places. Sulfur is already balanced at both of them. It is 1. Here also it is 1. Oxygen is here 4 and this is 5. Here oxygen is 4 and 5 and 6 is there. So oxygen is not balanced. And hydrogen is 4. Here it is 2. So if we will make it 2. 2 into 2, 4. Hydrogen is now balanced and oxygen, it is 4 and then 6. So now it is balanced. Okay. So this is how we can balance it. And this is neutralization reaction. This reaction is also called as neutralization. Okay. This is called as a neutralization reaction. Okay, now what happened when the reaction of the acid occur with the metal oxide? Reaction with the base, reaction with the metal oxide. Now see here, if we talk about the reaction with the metal oxide, acid react with the metal oxide. Metal oxide to form salt plus water. Metal oxide to give salt plus water. Okay. So here the acid, like hydrochloric acid is there. It will react with the metal oxide, that is copper oxide. Copper second oxide. Copper second oxide. Then there is a formation of a copper chloride, CuCl2. This is copper second chloride plus H2O will be released. Let us see whether it is balanced or not. So Cu is balanced, chlorine is 2 here, chlorine is 1 here. So we will write here 2. Now hydrogen is also 2, hydrogen is 1, 2 here, and oxygen is also balanced. So here, when the metal react with the metal oxide, then there is a formation of a salt and that of the water. We can take another example in which we made the hydrochloric acid to react with the calcium oxide. Calcium oxide, it will be in the solid state. This is an aqueous one, solid state. Then there is a formation of a CaCl CaCl2 equals plus H2. Again, this is now balanced. Okay, so this is what calcium oxide. The calcium oxide will react with the hydrochloric acid. Then there is a formation of a. So this sodium, this hydrochloric acid on reacting with the calcium oxide. This is calcium oxide. Then there is a formation of a calcium chloride. Calcium chloride. Okay, so hydrochloric acid on reacting with the calcium oxide gives the calcium chloride and water is released along with it. These are what, these are some of the chemical properties of that of the acid. Now, before we move on and try to understand the uses or that of the bases, let us see what are some of the physical properties of the acid. Physical properties of acid. The first physical property of acid is what? That acid have sour taste. Acids have sour taste. The second property is that acid turns blue litmus red. Blue litmus red. It means if you will take a blue litmus paper, it will turn into red color. Then next one is, acid is what? That is highly corrosive in nature. Okay, if we talk about the aqua regia, let me tell you about that. Where in the 3:1 we used to take the nitric acid and hydrochloric acid. It is supposed to be highly corrosive, that it can dissolve the gold also, which is very unreactive. Okay, so if we will take the gold and dissolve it into the nitric acid and that of the hydrochloric acid, it will not going to dissolve into it. But in aqua regia, it will get dissolved very easily. So acid turns blue litmus red. Then acids are what? Corrosive in nature. Acids are corrosive in nature. It is corrosive in nature. It means the concentrated one can burn the skin. Can burn the skin. Then acid or what? It produces a lot of ions through it. So we can say that they are helping. They ionizes. They get ionized in the water. So they act as an electrolyte. Okay, through which when the electricity passes through it, it can easily make the path for that of the electric current to flow through it. That's why, you know, like if you take about the citric acid, which is not very, very strong acid, but if you will take the two wires connect to the lemon juice, then yes, if an LED bulb is there, so it starts glowing. Yes, less amount of electric current will be produced, but yes, it will help in producing the electric current or making the electric charges to flow through it. So, the acids are electrolytes. That is, they ionize in water. They ionize in water. The other one, in aqueous medium, they act as an electrolyte. in aqueous medium acids conduct electricity. In aqueous medium it conduct electricity. Okay, these are some of the properties of the acids. These are the physical properties, and we have also understood that of the chemical properties also. Now let us move on and see that what are the different uses of that of the acids. So mainly the acid which we are knowing, see, other acids are the organic one, and we know that if you talk about citric or oxalic acid, we will get it from the fruits and the vegetables. What is the other uses of the mineral acids? Mineral acid includes the sulfuric acid, hydrochloric acid and the nitric acid. Talking about that of the hydrochloric acid, so hydrochloric acid are what? They help in removing the oxide layer when before that of the galvanization process. You know that the galvanization process is what? In which we used to make a layer on that of the iron metal, right? So the process of the galvanization can occur only when the surface is free from any kind of an oxide. So the removal of the oxide will be done with the help of the hydrochloric acid. The second one, it is used in, even in the textile, it is used in dye stuff, it is also used in the food as well as the leather industry. So these are what? These are some of the uses of the hydrochloric acid. If we talk about the sulfuric acid, so sulfuric acid is used, it is used in car batteries, it is also used in fertilizers. You have heard about the ammonium sulfate. So ammonium sulfate is what? It is a fertilizers, and here the sulfuric acid is used in order to prepare the ammonium sulfate. Then it is also used in the manufacture of the chemicals like that of the nitric acid or hydrochloric acid, that is also prepared with the help of the sulfuric acid. Then it is also used in making the synthetic fiber, in detergent, in paints. So in all of them sulfuric acid is used. Nitric acid, student, so nitric acid is used in making explosive. So you have heard about TNT, that is trinitrotoluene, TNT, trinitrotoluene, it is an explosive, and this is prepared with the help of the nitric acid, HNO3. Okay, so HNO3 is used for making the trinitrotoluene, that is TNT. Second one, it is also used for making the fertilizer, students. Like in case of a sulfuric acid, we have seen that ammonium sulfate is prepared by the sulfuric acid. Here, ammonium nitrate. Ammonium nitrate is used for NH4NO3. That is also prepared, that is used as a fertilizer, is prepared by the nitric acid. So ammonium sulfate, which is also used as a fertilizer, is prepared by sulfuric acid. Ammonium nitrate is prepared by nitric acid. Finally, it is also used for making dyes and plastics. Okay, so these are some of the uses of the different mineral acid, that is sulfuric acid, hydrochloric acid or nitric acid. Okay, so we have understood the uses and the properties. Now let us move on to the next one, and that is bases. What do we understand by the bases, students? So in a general term, before we were knowing the actual definition about the bases, which include the removal of the hydroxide ion or release of the hydroxide ion, we were knowing that bases are what? They are simply bitter in taste. Okay, and bases, they generally help in neutralizing the acid. So, but later on, bases are what? According to Arrhenius, the definition that we used to see in case of acid also, in case of a bases also, that release of a hydrogen ion or release of a hydroxide ion, this is an Arrhenius definition, student. Yes, there are other definitions has been given by Bronsted, Lowry and Lewis also, but that we will going to study in the higher section. Arrhenius, he has given the definition that when water is dissolved into the when water dissociated, it releases hydroxide ion, and the number of hydroxide ion help us in telling the basicity of a substance.